What up, players? It's Warboss Tape and it's Mug. Welcome to a July Painting Challenge video appreciation video. This one is for WarGamersSociety. We'll take a look at his page in just a little while, but he did an awesome project this month on the Hordes faction from Privateer Press, the Legion of Everblight. So I wanted to show you a little bit of them and do a little bit of a Fluff Hunters video. It's not going to be a full one because I'm not very familiar with Privateer Press games, with the fiction or the fluff or the rules or anything as much as I am with GW stuff, but I thought it would be cool to take a look at the miniatures because they produce some pretty cool looking stuff, and it looks like they're all about dragons and winged beasts and stuff. So I pulled up this battlecollege.wikispaces.com. It's the Legion of Everblight page, Battle College page. And so let's take a look at it and see what this Legion is about for anyone who's interested in starting it or in the models or anything like that. The Legion of Everblight relies on a combination of ranged attacks and incredibly powerful war beasts. The Legion war beasts are, apart from the lesser war beasts, the most powerful and cost the most points of all the Horde's factions. Legion is the second most popular faction in tournaments after Krix because they ignore the special rules and defenses of most other armies. In particular, a Legion army will demolish many Circle of Ouroboros forces with relative ease because they rely on concealment, stealth, forests, and difficult ground. So the first thing to note is the Legion is a beast faction. Put simply, the Legion's greatest strength is in the beasts in the model, in the army. With excellent fury support either through spells or solos, like the Forsaken or Shepherds, the Legion can run a surprisingly high number of war beasts. If you like to field big and impressive models surrounded by a flock of land sharks, you've come to the right place. Yeah, big bad monsters. With an abundance of abilities like Pathfinder, Flight, Stealth, or simply a high speed stat, the Legion usually has no issue getting its beasts where it wants. The Legion goes where it wants. Units and solos are another matter, but all of them usually retain some measure of alacrity not seen in other factions. The Seraph's Animus, the Legionnaire's Vengeance ability, or simply the Raptor's incredible alacrity are such examples. Big words. The Legion has great ranged capabilities, so Legion of Everblade is a ranged army. With Eyeless Sight, Legion armies can effectively ignore many common advantages that other factions struggle to deal with, or in some cases rely upon to defend themselves entirely. This especially comes into its own with the abundance of ranged attacks among the Legion's beasts. Of the Legion's 22 current beasts, 12 have ranged attacks, 4 of which are sprays and 2 of which are area of effects. Added to these are units like the Rangers and Raptors, and of course, Lilith throughout her incarnations. All in all, the dragons are fast, super, strong, specialized, expensive, and very, very killy, so take care of the glass cannon, and your opponent will be the one who gets shattered. Ooh, interesting. So this page seems to be a lot about tactics on all of the models, and we're not going to go into any of them really, but we'll just show them to you because this is a Fluff Hunters video, and we want to talk about the fluff, and we'll just read the first paragraph here, and then you can come and read the rest if you want. To understand the Legion of Everblight, you must understand the nature of dragons. Dragons are all immensely powerful creatures of godlike power. Even the weakest of them is a match for the mightiest of armies. With scales harder than tempered steel, claws that can rend even solid stone to rubble, and fiery breath that can reduce whole battalions of soldiers into mounds of ash, no mortal being has ever faced a dragon and succeeded in slaying it, and with good reason. That's just like my lady boss. But while their physical forms may evoke awe and dread, just like my lady boss, there is another aspect unique to all dragons that makes them truly exceptional and deadly. Ooh, what is it? Existing outside the natural order, the very existence of dragons is anathema to nature, and this fact is best expressed through what mortals refer to as blight. Blight is a warped energy radiated by all dragons into the land around them. The effects of dragon blight on the land are both incalculable and devastating. In even scant quantities, the taint of blight can corrupt virtually anything over time, poisoning rivers, eating away stone, and corroding metal. Ooh, interesting. So this is a totally interesting, unique take on dragons, how they affect their world, and it's something that is not really explored in other kinds of fiction, where the dragons are just there, and maybe they're big and bad and steal lots of gold and take over your dwarf hold, but they're not like physically altering and affecting the atmosphere around them and their environments, and I think that's pretty cool. So most things that I'm interested in are because of the miniatures, so I decided to look and find some good Legion of Everblight figures to look at, and here's one I found on Cool Mini or Not by this painter, Espa777. And I'm like, every time I look at Cool Mini or Not, I see an army or a unit done up with an awesome paint job with a fantastic looking base work. It makes me want to collect them. So even though I have no idea what this game is about, looking at these huge monstrous hulking beasts and these little squig-like looking ones, all controlled by this Warcaster, it is pretty cool. And I found it by, all I did was Google image, Google search Legion of Everblight, and I was searching and I found these terrific looking miniatures. So whenever I start a new army, the first thing I do is I look at the fluff, because if I'm not interested in the fluff, even if the models are super, super cool, like everything in Privateer Press's range, I'm not really going to be interested in it. That's the main reason why I haven't gotten into War Machine or Hordes. Also because the rules, it seems like with all the combos and everything, it might be just too much for me to wrap my head around. So I love looking or reading about the fluff. That's the first thing I like to do. And it seems like there's so much backstory and fiction for this faction. And once I figure out if I like it or not, of course I look at the miniatures themselves. And after that, I'll just take a look at the range on the website for the miniatures, and it just looks really cool. So this is all for my buddy WarGamersSociety, who did Legion of Everblight as his July painting challenge, and it was a terrific challenge. I don't know if he actually got to finish it, but I do know that he had some stumbles along the way with putting the miniature together, and also he found a paint scheme that he liked after he started painting. So that's happened to me so many times. I start painting a model and then I find a paint scheme or a color scheme and I'm like, oh, forget this paint scheme that I'm doing. I want to do that one. And it looks like he was able to come up with some good stuff. So I'm going to put his address into the link below. And I'd love it if you guys could go over, subscribe to him, send him a message, send him a comment on any of these videos, and tell him that I sent you and that you want him to finish his project. Because this whole community thing is just about finishing your project, you guys. So, WarGamersSociety, if you're watching this video, I would love it if you could give us an update on what you've been doing over these past couple of months. Let us know how your Legion of Everblight has grown, and show us some pictures of your work. All right, thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you guys enjoyed this little video appreciation video, rather. Switch them around. And we'll see you in the next video. Laters, players.